Welcome, my name is Stephen. I'll be guiding you this evening through our practice. So let's just begin in a comfortable cross-legged position. Sitting up nice and tall, allow the eyes to softly shut. Relax your shoulders down away from your ears, reaching your crown up into the sky. Start to let go of the dream that you call your life, let go of your stories, your drama, all that it took for you to get here, your bills, your responsibilities, your worries, your needs, your wants. I promise they will all be waiting for you an hour from now. The best thing you can do for them right now is just to bring all of that awareness, all of that effort into your breath. Inhaling in, down below the ribs, down into the belly, down into the diaphragm. Slowly exhaling it out the nose, pushing your belly button back towards your spine. Inhaling in, sitting up a little taller, reaching the crown of the head a little higher. Exhale, let your shoulders relax down away from your ears, your knees get a little closer down to the earth. Inhaling in deeply. Slowly exhaling it all out. And know that right now you are doing the most advanced posture in yoga. All of the moving asana, all of the challenges that we put ourselves through, are also that we can sit here for longer and longer periods of time just breathing. Without the distraction of a shoulder, without the distraction of our breath getting caught in our knee or in an elbow. So throughout our practice today, I want you to always come back to this same long inhale and long exhale, no matter where you find yourself. So with that in mind, on an inhale, inhale your arms out to the side, all the way up into the sky, feeling that length, reaching those fingertips, holding the breath at the top, bring the palms together and exhale them down in between the eyes to the third eye. May your practice cultivate enlightened thoughts. Inhale, exhale, the hands in front of the mouth. May your practice cultivate enlightened speech. Inhale, exhale, the hands in front of the heart. May all of your practices cultivate an enlightened heart. Reach down, grab your shins, change the crossing of your legs just to even out the body. It might feel a little strange. Your hip on this side might be a little tighter than the other. See if you can feel it relax. Place your palms down on your knees. Take a big inhale in, shining the heart, spilling the belly down over your shins. And then exhale, rolling back, pulling against your knees, sending the center of your back as far away from you as you can. Inhale, rolling forward. Shining the heart, looking up, opening the throat, inhaling it a little more in through the mouth. And then exhale, slowly rolling back, really pulling against those knees, letting your chin come down toward your pelvis. Push the center of your back a little farther away. Exhale out more air than you thought you could. And then inhale, rolling forward. This time as you exhale, pick a direction and just start to roll the entire body. Moving with your breath, you can let the head, neck, and shoulders go. Just feeling your breath circling through your body. Feeling your spinal cord, your spinal fluid, your whole nervous system waking up. And then start to take the circles in the opposite direction. Just moving with your breath. If you find a really good, juicy spot and you want to just take a few breaths, let it release and relax, and then keep the movement going. Just moving the whole spine, moving all of the breath. And then slowly coming back to center, sitting up tall, sit as still as you can, close your eyes, still feeling that internal movement of the nervous system, feeling it waking up. And then just start to bring your knees up into your chest, float your toes up off the earth, find that little spot between your sit bones and your tailbone and balance. Engage your core, shine your heart up, take the round out of the spine. And then bring your shins parallel to the earth, grab underneath your knees. Start to flex and point your toes. Just feeling that blood circulating all the way down to your toes, still breathing deep, still finding those same long inhales and long exhales. And then release the backs of your knees, start to reach your toes, down towards your toes. Maybe straightening the legs. You'll feel it a little more in the backs of the legs when you flex. Breathing deep. Point the toes, take a big inhale in. Exhale down just a few inches off the earth. Inhale yourself back up. Exhale down toward the earth. Inhale yourself up. Exhale yourself to float. Inhale yourself up. A few deep breaths. Reach down for those toes. Maybe keeping the knees bent parallel to the earth. And then just bring the knees up into your chest. Send your feet back behind you. Roll up over your hips and come into tabletop. Take a big breath in, push the tops of your feet down, drop the belly. And then exhale, reverse the motion, spreading the whole hand, pushing the whole hand down into the earth, inhaling up. Push the tops of the feet down, shoulders down away from your ears, and then exhaling, pushing it all out. Inhale up one more time. This time as you exhale, tuck the toes and find yourself in plank. Really push your heels back behind you, shoulders down away from your ears, spreading your fingers, pushing your whole palm down into the earth, reaching the crown of the head away, tucking your pelvis ever so slightly, feeling that long line of energy. Take a big inhale in here. Exhale down to Chaturanga. Get those shoulders way out over the fingertips. Relax all the way down on the earth, and then bring your forearms up in front of you and come up for Sphinx, pushing down with your whole palm, relaxing the shoulders down. Releasing the core, pushing the tops of your feet down into the earth, all 10 toes. And then just relax all the way down. You make a little pillow with your hand, turn on to one side. Take a few deep breaths, feeling your diaphragm pushing down into the earth. Feeling your breath as it's connected to the mat underneath you. And the earth underneath that. Feeling those long inhales and long exhales. And then as you're ready, start to reach your fingertips out in front of you. Reach your feet up off the earth and come into Shalabhasana. Gazing right in between your hands, you can spread the fingers to activate the arms. Breathing deep. Now your body may start to communicate to you, telling you, I do not want to be here. Why am I still holding myself up? See if you can just breathe a little deeper. Feel that slight little rock. See if you can get your feet and your hands just a little higher. Take one more big inhale. Reach the feet and hands a little bit higher up. Exhale, make a little pillow to place the other cheek down on the earth. A few deep breaths, feeling that diaphragm down. And then as you're ready, start to bend the knees, reach back for your ankles or the tops of your feet, and then start to kick into your hands to lift your heart up into the sky. Now, if you have your ankles like I do, flex your toes and think about getting your chest a little higher. If you have the tops of your feet, really point into the toes and think about getting your feet a little higher. Breathing so deep that you rock back and forth on your diaphragm, trying to bring your knees back in toward each other. One more big inhale in, get the feet a little higher. And then exhale, releasing down to the earth. Bring your hands right under your shoulders, big toes together. And send your hips back for child's pose. Feeling that counter of doing all of that work on the low back. And then feeling it release. The more you can reach your fingers away from you, sink your hips down towards your heels, the more that you'll feel the release in the low back. Know that this pose is there for you any time that you need it. My voice is only a guide. I only make suggestions for ways that you might take along this journey. If you ever feel disconnected from your breath, then please come back here, take a few deep breaths, reconnect with your breath, and then join us whenever you're ready. With that in mind, slowly coming up through tabletop, tuck your toes, send your hips up and back, and come into downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank. Exhale, down to Chaturanga. Get your shoulders way out over those fingers. Inhale through and up for Cobra. Maybe keeping those knees, those elbows bent. Exhale, tuck the toes, send it back, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank. Exhale, down to chaturanga. Spreading the fingers, inhale through and up. Cobra, maybe straightening the arms. Exhale, back, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank. Exhale, down to chaturanga. Inhale through and up, maybe all the way up to upward facing dog. Lick those kneecaps up off the earth. Exhale, back, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward to plank one more time. Exhale, down through chaturanga. Inhale, through and up. Take a few breaths in upward dog. Relax the shoulders down, spread the fingers. Maybe looking over the right shoulder and looking over the left. Take a big inhale in. As you exhale, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Inhale that right heel all the way up and back. Sink the heart down toward those left toes. Exhale, bring it through. Place that right foot down near the right hand. Sink the hips down. Keep the knee right over the ankle. Reaching that left heel back behind you. Keep that leg as straight as you can. Take an inhale in. Reach your arms out in front. Exhale, keep your chest down on that thigh. And then inhale yourself up for crescent pose. Put a little bend in that back knee if you need to, so you can tuck the pelvis underneath you. Take the arch out of the spine by engaging your core. Push that left heel back, straightening that leg as much as you can. Relaxing your shoulders down away from your ears. Breathing all the way through to your fingertips. Activating the triceps, activating the fingers. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, bring that left hand down to the inside of the right foot, right fingertips up into the sky. Finding those long inhales and long exhales, bending just a little more into that front knee so you can tuck that right hip underneath you so it's not sticking out to the side. Reaching that left heel back behind you, keeping that leg nice and straight. Trying to kiss your shoulder blades back behind you, maybe looking up toward that right thumb. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, reach your hand straight out in front of you. Inhale yourself back up to crescent pose. Feeling that strength for a breath or two, bending just a little more into that front knee. Take one more big inhale in. And then exhale, bring that chest down to your thigh. Place both hands to the inside of that right foot. Place that left knee down if you need to, and tuck the toes. Otherwise, keep reaching that right heel back, coming down to that left arm, maybe coming down to the right. Stopping anywhere along the way just to feel that right hip release. Breathing deep. And coming slowly back up to your hands. Place that left heel down. Inhale yourself up for Warrior One. See if you can get that left hip coming just as far forward as it was in crescent pose. Pushing down with the outside of that left foot, breathing all the way through to the fingertips. A few deep breaths, see if you can bend a little more into that front knee so you can pull that right heel back towards you to engage underneath that right thigh. Breathing deep. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, bend just a little deeper. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Exhale, bring the torso parallel to the earth. Bring the left hand down to the inside, the right foot. Right fingers up into the sky, twisting triangle. Breathing deep, finding those same long inhales and long exhales. See if you can open the heart just as much as it was in our twisted crescent. Spreading the fingers on the left and right hand, pushing down with that right big toe to keep that leg nice and straight. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, bend into that front knee. Inhale yourself right up to Warrior One. As you exhale, gracefully open into Warrior Two. You can bring that right heel in line with the left arch. Be sure that the right knee isn't collapsing into the left, pushing down with the outside of that left foot, relaxing the shoulders down, gazing right out over that right middle finger. Finding those same long inhales and long exhales, tucking your hips underneath you, trying to turn the insides of your thighs up toward the sky. Breathe. On an inhale, turn that right palm up. Send it back. Make your warrior peaceful. As much as you bend with that right knee, reach with the right fingertips. gazing up toward the right fingertips or down toward the outside of the left foot. See if you can take a little bit of weight off that left hand. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, bend just a little deeper. And then inhale, straighten that front leg. Start to reach the right hand down in between your shoulder blades, left hand up to meet the right. If you can interlace your fingers, hold on. Otherwise, just keep them reaching. Start to turn toward the front so you can see that right big toe, and then leaning back so you can feel the opening through the elbow, tricep, obliques, all the way through to the psoas. Take one more big inhale in. As you exhale, reach as far as you can with those right fingertips down toward the shin, peace grip, earth. Come into triangle. Taking a few deep breaths, trying to tuck that right hip underneath you so it's not sticking out to the side. Pushing down with that right big toe. If you're feeling this in your left obliques, I want you to come up just a little bit on that right leg so that you can find a straighter spine, so you can feel it more on the bottom of that right leg. Breathing deep, finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Pushing down with the outside of that left foot, pushing down with that right big toe. Take a big inhale in. As you exhale, start to bend into that right knee, bring the right elbow up to that right thigh, come into extended side angle, reaching the left arm up over your ear. If that left thigh is pointing down to the earth, bring the left heel in, turn the left toes out so you can turn that thigh up into the sky. Feeling the opening in the hips, really pushing with that right elbow to open that right knee just a little bit more. Maybe bringing the right hand down to the earth, left arm up into the sky, bending generously into that front knee. We're almost there. See if you can open just a little more over that left shoulder. Take one more big inhale in. And as you exhale, place your hands down, send that right foot back to meet the left. Take a big inhale in plank. Exhale down through your vinyasa. Inhale through and up. And just go ahead and exhale back to child's pose. Let your knees be nice and wide, big toes together. Forehead down on the earth. Taking a few deep, well-deserved breaths. You can sigh it out if you'd like. Taking a big inhale in. Opening the mouth and just feeling your body relaxing into your breath. Being kind and patient with yourself. See if you can notice the slight difference between the right side and the left side of your body. Start to prepare the breath and the mind moving on to the left side. And you know where we're heading on our series on the left side. So I want you to really think about your transitions in between each of the poses. The transitions are just as important as the postures. When you can find the same breath, the same sense of peace in each of your transitions, you'll find that each of the poses become a little easier, a little calmer. So with that in mind, slowly inhale yourself up through tabletop. Exhale back to downward facing dog. Inhale that left heel all the way up and back, sinking that heart down toward those right toes. Exhale it through and come into a nice high lunge. Really sink the hips down, reach that right heel back behind you. Keep that right leg as straight as you can. When you feel stable here, where you can still pull that left heel back toward you without the knee coming out over the toes, inhale your arms out in front of you. And then exhale, keeping your chest down on that thigh. Inhale yourself right up for crescent pose. Breathing deep, put a little bend in that knee if you need to, so you can tuck the pelvis underneath you, engage the core, take the arch out of the spine, and then push the right heel back behind you so you feel it in the top of that right hip. Relax the shoulders down. Breathe all the way through to your fingertips. Take one more big inhale. Exhale, bring the right hand down to the inside of the left foot, left fingers up into the sky, trying to kiss the shoulder blades back behind you. Breathing deep. Finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Try to tuck that left hip underneath you, bending just a little more into that left knee, spreading the fingers on the right and left hands. Take one more big inhale in. As you exhale, reach your hands straight out in front of you, and then inhale yourself back up to crescent pose. Breathing deep, trying to sink into those front left knees, relaxing the shoulders down. Beautiful. Engaging the triceps. One more big inhale in. Exhale, bring the chest down. Bring the hands to the inside of the left foot. Place that right knee down if you need to. Untuck the toes. Otherwise, keep reaching that right heel back. Maybe coming down to that right forearm. Maybe coming down to the left. Letting that left hip release. Finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Getting your breath loud enough that you can hear it. Any time that your body starts to tell you, I'm tired, I want to come out, see if you can just find a deeper breath. And I promise you will find more strength than you knew you had. Tucking those right toes back behind you if they aren't already. Coming up to your hands, place that right heel down. Inhale yourself all the way up into Warrior One. Trying to push down with the outside of that right foot, still bringing the right toes toward the front of your mat, bending into that front knee, pulling that left heel back toward you, engaging the core, take the round out of the spine, breathing deep. Take one more big inhale in, exhale, bend just a little deeper. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Exhale, the torso parallel to the earth. Bring the right hand to the inside of the left foot. Left fingers up into the sky. Still pushing down with the outside of that right foot. Pushing down with the left big toe. Reaching all the way through the left fingertips, spreading the fingers on the left and right hand so the whole palm can push down on the earth. If you can't quite reach the earth, you can come up to your fingertips. Maybe bringing that right hand up to that left shin. Feeling the length in your spine as the crown of your head reaches away from you as well as the twist. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, bend into that front knee. Reach the arms out. Inhale yourself up to Warrior One. As you exhale, gracefully open into Warrior Two. Beautiful. Be sure that that left knee's right out over the toes. It's not collapsing into the side. Trying to tuck the hips underneath you to open them out to the sides, pushing down with the outside of that right foot. Relax the shoulders down. Finding that breath. Take one more inhale in. Exhale, bend just a little deeper. Inhale, turn that left palm up. Send it back. Make your warrior peaceful. Gazing up toward those left fingers outside of the right foot. As much as you reach with the left fingers, bend with that left knee. Finding those long inhales, long exhales. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Bring the left hand down in between the shoulder blades. Right hand up to meet the left. Turn toward those front toes, and then lean back, trying to gaze up toward the sky to open up the shoulder, obliques, psoas. Still breathing deep. One more inhale in. As you exhale, unwind, reaching the left fingers as far as you can down toward the shin, beast grip, earth, right fingers up, tucking that left hip underneath you, pushing down with the outside of the right foot, finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Again, if you're feeling it at all in the right obliques, come up just a little bit on that left hand so you can find a straight spine. Trying to kiss your shoulder blades back behind you. Finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Take one more big inhale in. As you exhale, bend into that front knee. Bring the left elbow up to that left thigh. Bring that right heel in so you can turn your right hip up toward the sky. Pushing out on that left knee to open the hips just a little more. Reaching the right arm up over your ear. Gazing up underneath your elbow. Maybe bringing that left hand down to the earth. Really pushing out with that left elbow. Reaching that right arm. Take one more big inhale wherever you are. And then exhale, place your hands down. Send that left foot back to meet the right. Take a big inhale in plank. Exhale, down to chaturanga, way out over those fingertips. Inhale through and up. And then exhale back to child pose. Let the knees be nice and wide, big toes together. Relaxing the forehead down on the earth. Taking a few well-deserved, deep breaths. Be allowing a few sighs of affirmation. Feeling the body warm. Feeling the breath coming easier and easier. We're going to move through some balancing postures. And as we do, I want you to just concentrate on your breath the whole time. Don't think about your foot down on the earth. Your foot will find its balance if you can find your breath. And remembering those transitions, especially in these balancing postures, when we can move with grace and stability through each of our transitions, we'll find that the balancing postures get a little easier, a little easier. Slowly coming up through tabletop, send the hips up and back, come into downward facing dog. Inhale that right heel all the way up and back. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale that right heel all the way up and back. Exhale, knee to left elbow. Inhale that heel all the way up. Exhale the right knee to the right elbow. Take a few breaths, trying to get that knee all the way up into your armpit. And then softly place that right foot down near the right hand. When you feel stable here, just like we were a moment ago, inhale your arms out in front of you. Start to take your weight forward and then up. And gracefully find your way into Warrior Three. Arms out in front of you. Arms out to the side, heart center, finding that one spot down on the earth at which to gaze. Flexing those left toes, thinking about your chest and your heel up into the sky. Finding those long inhales and long exhales. Beautiful. Oh, you're all so still. I love it. And then ever so slowly, start to reach the right fingertips down toward the earth. Bring that left hand to your hip to open up the shoulder into the sky. Maybe reaching those left fingertips up. Maybe floating off onto one finger. Maybe floating just a few inches off the earth, flexing those left toes. Maybe bringing that right hand near that right shin. Take one more big inhale in. Reach those right fingertips down. And then reach the left hand down. Take the place of the right. See if you can tuck that left hip underneath you so that your toes are pointing the opposite direction. And then reach the right hand up into the sky, coming into twisting half moon. I know it's a strange posture. See if you can breathe through it. Beautifully done. Take one more big inhale in. Exhale, bring the right hand down. Get that left heel just a little higher up into the sky, coming into standing splits. And then see if you can gracefully start to find that center of balance coming through Warrior Three. Bring that left knee all the way up into your chest, coming standing on that right leg. I know that right leg's starting to feel it. Find a little deeper breath. Find that one spot at which to gaze. Think about the crown of your head up into the sky and holding on to that left knee with the right hand. Start to reach back with the left. Or you can grab a peace grip around those toes and start to straighten the leg. Breathing deep. You can gaze back toward that backhand. If you come out of balance, don't worry about it. We come out of balance all the time in life. What's important is how long it takes us to try to come back. Slowly bring that knee back up into your chest. Hold on to the inside of the left foot with the left hand. Reach that right arm out in front of you. I hope that right leg is starting to feel it. Coming all the way up through Dancer. Take a big breath in. And then as you exhale, gracefully place that left foot down and the hands to heart center. Close the eyes. Standing for the first time in our practice for just a breath. And then inhale the arms out to the side, all the way up into the sky. Exhale, fold down over the legs. Release and relax. Put a little bend in that left knee. Keep the left hand reaching down to the earth. Reach the right fingertips up into the sky. Opening up the outside of that right leg after all of that wonderful work it just gave us. The more you straighten that left leg, the more that you'll feel the twist. Just breathing deep and relaxing. Thanking that right leg for all of its work. And then placing your hands down on the earth. You can step or jump back through your vinyasa. Exhale down through chaturanga. Inhale through and up. Exhale back, downward facing dog. Take a few deep breaths. Everybody take a big inhale in through the nose. Hold the breath at the top. Open the mouth and sigh it out. Beautiful. One more time. Big inhale in through the nose. Hold the breath at the top. Open the mouth and sigh it out. I love it. All right, you know where we're headed. Inhale that left heel all the way up and back. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale that left heel all the way up and back. Exhale the left knee over to that right elbow. Inhale that heel all the way up and back. Sink the heart just a little more. Exhale the left knee to the left elbow, trying to get it all the way up into that armpit, engaging your core, reaching that right heel back. Relax your shoulders down away from your ears. And then softly place that left foot down near the left hand. When you feel stable here, just like we were before, feeling that stability in the left foot, reach the arms out in front of you. Take the weight forward and inhale yourself gracefully up to Warrior Three. Arms out in front, out to the side, heart center. Heart center is going to be the easiest, just to find your breath, thinking about that. Heel up into the sky, shoulders up, breathing deep, finding that breath, finding your breath, and you'll find your balance. And then gracefully remembering that the transitions are just as important as the poses, slowly reach those left fingertips down, really flexing those right toes, stacking the hips by bringing the right hand up to your hip, opening that right shoulder into the sky. Maybe reaching the right fingertips up, finding those deep breaths, maybe floating up to one finger on that left hand, maybe floating up off the earth, maybe bringing that left hand toward that left shin. And then as you're ready, start to bring that right hand down, take the place of the left, tuck that right hip underneath you so your left hip really opens to the side, and then reach the left arm up. Trying to kiss the shoulder blades back behind you, scissoring your hips underneath you, flexing those right toes, pointing them over to the left side if you can. One more inhale here. As you exhale, bring both hands down, get that right heel a little higher up into the sky and standing splits, knee to nose. And then gracefully, like a pendulum, see if you can feel that balance. Coming through Warrior Three, bring that right knee up into your chest, breathing deep, holding on to that right knee with the left hand, reach back with the right fingers, maybe grabbing a peace grip around those toes, straightening that leg, finding those long inhales and long exhales. Slowly bringing that knee back up into your chest. holding onto the inside of the right foot with that right hand. Send it back behind you. Reach out with that left hand, kick into the right. Breathe. We're almost there. One more big inhale in. And then exhale, place that right foot gracefully down. Bring the hands to heart center. Close the eyes. Take a big inhale in. Open the mouth and sigh it out. We have made it. Inhale the arms down, out and up. Exhale, leading with the heart. Relaxing down, keeping that right hand reaching down. Bend into that right knee. Reach the left fingertips up. Opening up the outside of that left hip. And then relaxing down in a nice forward fold. Place your hands down on the earth. Step or float back down through your vinyasa. Inhale through and up. Exhale back, downward facing dog. Inhale that right heel up and back. Exhale it forward for pigeon prep. Bring that right foot toward the left. Right knee down toward the right. Start crawling that left foot back behind you. And then slowly making your way down, relaxing over that front leg. If you'd like, you can bring the left knee to come right up to that right foot. Come down for a nice modified pigeon. It's the same release in that hip, keeping those right toes nice and flexed so that the opening comes in the hip and not in the knee. Taking a few deep, well-deserved breaths. With every breath, finding one more muscle to relax, one more joint. And as we start to cool down, your mind may start to come back. And just notice what you're saying to yourself. Are they words of kindness and encouragement? Are they words of frustration and impatience? I love what Eckhart Tolle says. If you want to know what your life is going to be like 5 years from now, then notice what you're saying to yourself in your head right now. So is your life looking like a life of patience and kindness? Or one of frustration and anger? As you're ready, slowly coming back up to your hands. Tuck the left toes back behind you. Send that right foot back to meet the left. And shake out that right hip however you need to. And as you're ready, take a big inhale through plank. Head through our final vinyasa. Exhale down, way out over those fingers. Inhale through and up. Exhale back. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale that left heel all the way up and back. Exhale, bring the left ankle toward that right wrist. Left knee toward the left. Start to walk those right toes back behind you so you can get your hips down on the earth. And as you're ready, start to walk down to the forearms, relaxing the forehead. And again, bringing that right knee up toward the left foot if you need to so you can still relax down. Letting that hip release and relax. I was listening to Stephen Hawking the other day talk about string theory, and for the first time it kind of made a little sense. And he was talking about how inside of our atoms are these theorized quarks, and inside of quarks there are strings, actual strings that vibrate. And they can vibrate harmoniously, like a string quartet, or disharmoniously, like a child learning how to play a violin for the first time. And those vibrations in all of these strings that exist at this subatomic level, they determine how we perceive our reality. And what determines how those strings vibrate are electrical impulses or thoughts. So how are your thoughts vibrating? What is it that you're thinking about right now? It's being transferred to these little strings, vibrating inside of these quarks, inside of atoms, inside of your cells, inside your organs, inside your brain, inside your memories, inside that left hip that just won't seem to relax as much as I want it to. See if words of affirmation, kindness, and gratitude maybe start to change that vibration. Change your breath. Slowly coming back up to your hands. Tuck the right toes back behind you. Send that left foot back. You can roll out that hip however you need to. And as you're ready, place it down. Coming back into downward facing dog. Last downward dog of the day. Sinking those heels down. Inhale, come up to the balls of your feet, turn your gaze forward, step or float to the front of your mat. And exhale down in a nice forward fold. Heel toe your feet out to the edges of your mat. And then turn your toes out, send your hips down to the earth. Bring your elbows right into your knees, sitting up nice and tall. Bring your hands to heart center. Taking a few deep breaths. Now, if you'd like, you can stay here. You can place your hands down on the earth, get your knees up over your elbows, one toe at a time, make your way up to crow. Otherwise, just reach that right hand to the outside of the right foot, left fingers up into the sky. Breathing deep. And then as you're ready, reach that left hand to the outside of the left foot, right fingertips up. And then when you're ready, everyone slowly meet us back in a nice easy squat. Place your hips down on the earth, bring your knees up into your chest, float your toes. Since our core is from where all of our strength comes, just spend a little more time there. Bring your feet out, holding underneath your knees, shining the heart up, straightening the legs if you can, releasing the fingers down toward the toes. Bring your hands together, reaching down towards your toes. Take a big inhale in. Exhale over to the right. Inhale through center. Exhale to the left. Inhale through center. Exhale to the right. Inhale through center. Exhale to the left. Inhale through center. Take a few deep breaths, just reaching down, engaging your core, shining the heart. Take one more big inhale in. Slowly exhaling it out, just to floating all the way down to the earth. Bring your knees up into your chest. And then place the soles of your feet down on the earth, hip distance apart. Push down with your heels, lift your hips up into the sky, tuck one shoulder blade and then the other, interlace your fingers and come up for bridge. Or if you have an Ardha Dhanurasana practice, place your hands right underneath your shoulders, push yourself up and come up for half wheel, releasing the front of the body, trying to release your glutes, feeling them relax as your heart reaches a little higher into the sky. Breathing deep, take one more big inhale in, and as you exhale, roll down one vertebra at a time. If you're inverting today, go ahead and bring your knees up into your chest, send your feet up over your head, and come in to plow. If you're not inverting today, bring the soles of your feet together. Let your knees relax out to the side. Right hand to your heart, left hand to your belly, and come into Supta Baddha Konasana. For those of you that have come back for plow, if you'd like to make your way up to shoulder stand, bring your hands as high up on your back as you can, elbows in toward each other, balls of your feet up toward the sky. Be sure that there's no weight in your neck, it's all in your shoulders.
Breathing deep, finding a little stillness. Finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Slowly rolling back through plow. Maybe death man's pose, balancing your knees on your forehead. And then one vertebra at a time, rolling down to the earth. Hug your knees in. If you're coming up from Supta Baddha Konasana, just go ahead and hug your knees in. Holding onto that right leg, straighten the left leg out onto the earth. You can keep that left knee bent, or you can start to straighten the right leg. Maybe holding onto the back of the thigh, back of the calf, peace grip around those right toes. Breathing deep, stopping anywhere along the way. If that right leg is straight, hold on to the right leg with just the left hand. Let the right arm fall out to the side. If the knee is bent, hold on to the knee with the left hand. And then just start to pull the right leg over the body. If that right leg is straight, see if you can start to bend the left knee, reaching for the toes with that right hand. Letting that very last vertebra release and relax with every breath. Slowly breathing, feeling the twist as well as the length in the spine. Bringing your knees back up into your chest. Really holding on to that left knee. Let the right leg straighten out. And straighten that left leg, holding on behind the thigh, calf, peace grip around those toes. Flexing both toes, breathing deep. Holding on to that left leg, if it's straight, you can grab onto it with just the right hand. If it's bent, hold on to that left knee with the right. And then just slowly pull the left leg over the body. If that left leg is straight, or you'd like, you can bend that right knee, reaching for the top of the right foot with the left hand. Feeling that very last vertebra release and relax. Finding those same long inhales, long exhales. Breathing deep and relaxing for these last few moments. And then so slowly, bring both knees back up into your chest. Give yourself a well-deserved hug. And then extend everything out into our final shavasana. Tuck one shoulder blade and then the other. Let your toes fall away from each other, closing the eyes. If your tongue is connected to the roof of your mouth, release it so that you can feel that clear passageway of air in and out of your nose. Feeling the weight of your bones, the weight of your muscles, the weight of every cell in your body, heavy, sinking down, supported by the earth underneath you. Allow yourself just to breathe. Allow yourself just to be. Slowly allow your awareness to come back to your breath and just notice how you're breathing. See if you can feel your breath in your fingertips and your toes. Run your thumbs over your fingertips. Roll your wrists, ankles, knees, elbows, shoulders, hips. Rock your head from side to side. Stretch your arms up above you, away from your toes, like you're waking up from the best dream. And keeping the eyes softly shut, rolling onto one side or the other, slowly find your way back to that same comfortable cross-legged position in which we started class. Bringing it all full circle. Sitting comfortably, sitting tall. Finding those same long inhales and long exhales. Notice if you're sitting a little easier, if your breath is coming a little calmer, and if your thoughts seem just a little bit further apart. Inhale the arms out to the side, all the way up into the sky. Hold the breath at the top. Bring the palms together and the energy of our entire class and exhale it all down in between the eyes to the third eye. May your life be filled with enlightened thoughts. Inhale, exhale the hands in front of the heart, the mouth. May you always have the patience for enlightened speech. Inhale, exhale the hands in front of the heart. May your heart have the healing it requires to live an enlightened life. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for allowing me to guide you. Again, my name is Steven. For those of you here at the studio, there's a donation box in the back. For those of you at home, there's a donation button on your screen. No amount is too small and is greatly appreciated so that we can continue to bring yoga to anyone and everyone here in LA and around the world. So thank you all so much. And just remember that change doesn't happen just with the time that we spend on our mats. Change happens with every conscious breath that we take in our lives. As always, peace be with you. Thank you so much.